Hello, folks. Your library in HelpNDoc is a central storage area where you maintain your media files for your entire project. Once added to the library, items can be used throughout the documentation project. The library supports several multimedia file formats, including images and photographs, movies, documents, raw HTML code, variables, which are placeholders for simple textual data, and snippets, which are placeholders for complex formatted text. In this video, we are going to show you how to add an item to your library. Let's begin with adding a picture to your library first. Click the Add Item button in the Library group on the Home Ribbon tab. This displays a pop-up menu with multiple items to choose from. Now, select the Add Picture option. This displays the Picture Properties window for you to enter the name of the item, as well as select one of the following Include options. Select Include File and Project to import the image into your project. Clicking the No File Included link displays a pop-up menu. Now select the Include File option to open the File Browser window. Locate the file you wish to include in your documentation, select it, and click on the Open button. Note the No File Included link has now changed to One File Included. Or you can select the Include a File at Generation Time so that HelpNDoc will load and include the image from your hard drive when you generate your documentation. It will not be displayed in your text editor. Instead, a placeholder image with the file path is displayed in your text editor. Here, click on the File Browse icon to the right to browse for your file. Select the file of your choosing and click Open. The path to your file located on your hard drive can now be seen in the File Location text box. You can also select to display a URL at viewing time in order to display a URL in your published documentation. A placeholder image with the URL will be displayed in your text editor. Once finished entering the properties, click OK to save it in your library and close the window. A second method of adding a picture to your documentation is to simply right-click anywhere in your library panel, which will then display a pop-up menu similar to before. Click Add Item, and then select the Add Picture option from the pop-up menu. The Picture Properties window will pop up as before, leaving you to fill in the properties as necessary. If you would like to add a movie to your documentation, either click the Add Item button in the Library group on the Home tab and select Add Movie, or right-click anywhere in the Library panel, hover over the Add Item option from the pop-up menu, and then select Add Movie. As before, it opens the Item's Properties box, allowing you to enter the name of the item and define its properties. Include File in Project imports the movie into the project and displays a placeholder image in your text editor. It also displays the video player in your published documentation. Click No File Included as before, and then select Include File from the pop-up menu to display the File Browser window that allows you to navigate to the file. Select the movie file you wish to include in the project and click Open. Once again, notice that the No File Included link now changes to One File Included. The Include a File at Generation Time option has HelpNDoc load and include the movie from your hard drive when you generate your documentation. Here also, click on the File Browse icon to the right to browse for your movie file. Select the movie file of your choosing and click Open. Notice once again, the file path to the movie file will now be displayed in the File text box for your reference. And lastly, display a URL at viewing time lets you enter the URL for a video that you'd like to show from an online resource. Once again, a placeholder image with the URL will be displayed in your text editor. We now need to set the dimensions of the movie that we want the video player to show in your documentation. In the properties box below, enter the width and height in pixels to determine the size of the video player that will be displayed in your published documentation. Now click OK to save this movie item in your library and close the window. To add a document to your project, use one of the methods previously shown to open the Add Item Options menu, and then select the Add Document option to open the Document Properties box. Enter the name of the document item, and then select one of the options below. Include File and Project imports the document file in your project, displaying a placeholder in the text editor, which is then replaced when generating the documentation. Click the No File Included link to display the file browser as before to select the document to include in your project. Include a file at generation time, again, will load and include an external document from your hard drive when you generate your documentation. As before, click on the File Browse icon to the right here to browse for the file, which then displays the file path in the file text box once again. When done entering the properties, click OK to save it in your library and close the window. The Add HTML Code Properties box allows you to embed raw HTML code into your published documentation. When you insert HTML code, it is inserted in your HTML-based documentation, such as the CHM, HTML, EPUB, or Kindle, for example. However, only a placeholder is displayed in your text editor. When you insert variables into your text editor, the name of the variable is displayed. However, when you publish your documentation, the current value assigned to that variable is displayed instead. Changing the value of a variable in the library will automatically update all of its references throughout the project. Snippets contain rich text content that can be formatted and include images. After creating a snippet in your central library, you can insert it once or many times to reuse this rich text content throughout your entire project. When you update a snippet in your central library, that change is automatically reflected wherever the snippet has been inserted in your documentation. Once a library item has been added, it is possible to include it in as many topics as needed. When the item is updated in the library, the change will automatically propagate to every topic using it. HelpNDoc is free for personal use and evaluation purposes. You can download it at helpndoc.com and see other video guides at helpndoc.com/online-help. Thanks for watching.